relationship. How to build relationship, importance of relationship, how to continue on the relationship, and what is the benefit of having good relationship. Different areas we'll try to cover. Have you heard the name of Dhruva Maharaj? From Srimad Bhagavatam. How many of you know him? Please raise your hand. Okay. You don't know. Dhruva Maharaj is a character from Srimad Bhagavatam. So how many of you know what is Srimad Bhagavatam? Little bit of idea, Srimad Bhagavatam. Okay. Prabhupada said that Bhagavad Gita is high school study. Srimad Bhagavatam is university study. Chaitanya Charitamrita is PhD study. So, having idea of Srimad Bhagavatam is necessary, but you are not so old in Krishna consciousness, maybe you have some little idea of Srimad Bhagavatam. But Dhruva Maharaj is a character in Srimad Bhagavatam. At the age of 5, he left home for spiritual search. How many of you are 5 years old here? No. So Dhruva Maharaj was exceptional. At the age of 5, people like to play. People like to have some fun, but at the age of 5, Dhruva Maharaj left home for spiritual search. And while he was on the way to Vrindavan, so Narada Muni met him. You know Narada Muni, right? Have you heard the name of Narada Muni?
Yes.
Very good. Everybody knows. Whether they know Srimad Bhagavatam, Narada Muni is very popular. People know in a different way, but Narada Muni is a very popular character. So Narada Muni gave so many instructions to Dhruva Maharaj, but one of the instructions is connected with our topic. So Narada Muni told Dhruva Maharaj, if you are to be free from the effects of this material world, from the suffering of this material world, if you follow this instruction, you will be free from this. So the instruction is based on relationship. He says, if you see somebody advanced than you or senior to you, you should feel very happy and jubilant and serve him. If you see somebody equal to you, then you should develop friendship with him. And if you see more less qualified than you, you see someone who is not qualified like you, then you should be compassionate and help him to bring him up to a level. And if you do this, then you will be free from the suffering. You will not be affected. Rather, material nature cannot touch you. And you will be completely happy in your life. So this is the principle of the relationship. Generally, we deal with three categories of people. Some are senior to us, some are equal to us, and some are junior to us. And we have to know how to build relationship with them. And very nicely, Narada Muni is analyzing this principle to Dhruva Maharaj. And it's very deep instruction. And if we can apply this instruction in our life will be successful. So he said, if someone is advanced than you, you should feel happy and joyful. If you see someone equal to you, what should be the feeling? Develop friendship. If someone is less qualified or junior to you, you should have compassion and try to bring him up. But that is not the principle followed in this world. Principle followed in this world is completely opposite to this instruction. If we see somebody senior to us, advanced than us, we become envious. If we see somebody equal to us, we try to impress them by our achievements. We have a tendency to impress. And if we meet someone who are less qualified than us, then we try to exploit them. And that is the nature of this world. Clear? So two opposite. Narada Muni's instruction and the reality in this world. And that is our spiritual journey to reach to the level of Narada Muni's instruction. So first is that we have to be free from envy. If there is envy and ego, just like when we see someone senior to us, we become envious. And if we see somebody equal to us, we try to impress them, is ego. So our relationship is spoiled. Rather, we cannot develop any relationship, genuine relationship, because we are affected by envy and ego. And that is the characteristics we have in this world. So in this world, everybody is thinking what he will get. Right or wrong? People say superficially, I love you. Common word, very widely used sentence, I love you. Right or wrong? No? You have heard this sentence before? Or hearing first time? So you heard, huh? Okay, thank you. So you are on the same page. We tell this sentence but without understanding the meaning of love. I love you. What is the meaning of love? That has to be understood. There are many meanings. But the love means giving. Love means sacrifice. Love means performing the duty. But in this world, love means what I'll get, not give. Kya milega? Inke saath jur raha hu, is jurne se kya milega mere ko? Right or wrong? I am building relationship with you, mere ko kya milega? Right or wrong? Everybody is thinking like that. This is not love. So relationship, genuine relationship is built up when you think that what I can do for you, what can I give, that is the principle of relationship. Spiritual world is the world of giving, but material world is the world of getting. What I will get, that's why the definition of so-called love in this world is get, and then forget. But the real definition of love is give, and then forget.
Forgive.
What is it? Forget. So that is the principle we follow. We like to forget. Get and forget. Right or no? So what you want to do? You want to get and forget, or you want to give and forget? What is good?
Give.
Huh? Kya milega? Very acha. So, because we have a very strong selfish nature, and with that also we enter into spiritual life. So, when we enter spiritual life, we also think, kya milega? Prabhu ji bol rahe hai, japa karo. To kya milega? 8 mala karne se kya milega? 16 mala karne se kya milega? Tab to karunga na. Kya milega? So in the same spirit we enter into association of devotees and have the same tendency. What I will get out of it? And that's why we are not experiencing the joy of Krishna consciousness. When you exploit, exploitation leads to frustration. When we have envy and when we have ego, we have a natural tendency to exploit. This world is the world of exploitation. But spiritual world is the world of service. When you serve, then you get joy. And when you exploit, what you get? Exploitation leads to frustration. Now people are frustrated. Whether you're in America, whether you're in Australia, whether you're in Africa, whether you're in India, whether you're in China, whether you're in Japan, wherever you are frustrated. But you are thinking, by changing our place, our life will improve. Right? That's why those who are in India, thinking, when I can go to? Where? America. Then people will be very happy if you go there, right? And American people are thinking, oh, when I can go to India and become happy like Indians? People are thinking like that. So American people are thinking, Indian people are very happy, and Indian people are thinking, American people are very happy. Even if you tell this, Prabhu, anyway will be happy, unhappy, so better to be unhappy in America. Right? So we have that feeling and faith. This is called belief system. We have a strong belief system that changing place, changing country, changing situation of life will make us happy. But that is not the way to experience happiness. That's why we always try to improve our situation. Our belief system is very strong and we always want to improve our situation. And how we can improve our situation? If you have a good house, you are not happy with that. Maybe you are in 2 BHK flat. But you are not happy with that because you want to improve. So you are thinking that 2 BHK is not enough for me to be happy. I should have 3 BHK, 4 BHK, 5 BHK. So how many BHKs are available in the Calcutta? 4, 5 not available. Eh? Then we have penthouse. I don't know, you know, in Calcutta they are building or not. Penthouse, then villa, then palace. So many varieties. Thinking that increasing the number of bedrooms, we can increase our happiness. Excellent. But whether you are having 2 BHK or 3 BHK or 50 BHK, the life partner is the same. Technique. So you are not changing your life because she will be there and he will be there with you and you will continue the same life whether you are 2 BHK or 20 BHK. So by increasing bedroom is not the principle to increase your happiness. But we think like that. That's why we are very busy in upgrading our situation. Why I am telling on this? Because that is the belief system. And that's why people are frustrated. Because we think things will give us happiness. Things will give us happiness. Good house, good car, good clothes, good gadgets will make us happy. That is the belief system. That's why they are upgrading. They are upgrading their house, upgrading their car also. Starting our journey with bike. Before marriage, bike is okay. In Calcutta, the bike is dangerous though. Still, just like 2 BHK, just in the same way, 2 wheelers. 2 is very good when you are alone. But when 1 becomes 2, then 2 wheeler is not enough. Because each person needs 2 wheels. So 4 wheels become 2 wheels become 4 wheels. Right or not? So starting with Maruti Suzuki. So to start with, if you don't have handsome salary, then starting with Maruti Suzuki is okay. But you are not happy because your goal is something high. You started your journey with Maruti Suzuki. Then maybe after that, Swift Desire, little upgraded. Although Maruti, but little upgraded. Then if you have more money, I don't know Calcutta, how it is, what kind of brand they are using nowadays. Then BMW, then Calcutta. And then BMW, after that, Audi. Mercedes Benz, then? Already they are on the right track. Then Lamborghini. Then I think most expensive car in the world now is Rolls Royce, right? If I get Rolls Royce, then my life is successful. But whether you in Rolls Royce, whether you are in BMW or Audi or you are in Maruti Suzuki, traffic jam of Calcutta will remain the same. By changing your car, you are not going to change the traffic system of Kolkata or any other city of India. That will remain the same. Now, gaadi ho gaya, makan bhi ho gaya. Abhi, pehenne ka cheez, branded garments. And if you feel that if I wear some branded clothes, I'll look better. Whether you are wearing branded or not branded, you look the same. But we have a system. If I wear some expensive branded clothes, I look better. You are not going to look better, but we think like that. Not only we, the whole world thinks like that. That's why they are selling products. They are selling, smoke this cigarette, you will feel cool. And people believe that. Fire is entering into your system and they are telling that you will feel cool. And people are buying that. That is the potency of advertising. Very powerful. So you think that things will make us happy. So people are happy. When Prabhupada went to America, they had all these things in abundance. They don't have to try. They don't have to go to engineering college, have some degree, do some job, do some business, then get money, then enjoy. No. From their birth, they are enjoying, which is beyond our imagination being Indians. After enjoying so much, they became hippies. They did not become. Why? Exploitation leads to frustration. Things cannot make you happy. People will make us happy. Why people are so frustrated in the modern world? Because they are spending most of their time with things. Mainly with the results. That is the main problem of the modern world. Husband and wife are in the same room, sitting next to each other, but they are calling to different persons from their mobile phones. We have thousands of Facebook friends, but there is no real friend in our life. So many likes in our social media, but nobody likes us in our real life. That is the reality. We are living in fantasy world. Already we are in fantasy, which real world itself is a fantasy. We are, the soul is a real identity, and in this material world we are thinking we are this body. That is fantasy world. We are thinking which we are not. But now we are not thinking we are this body. We are thinking we are the picture. Right or no? And wherever you go, whether it's temple, whether it's park, whether you are any good place, everywhere people are busy in taking selfie. Nowadays nobody is interested in self-realization. Everybody is interested in self-realization. So self has been replaced by selfie. Right or not? And nobody is glorifying ourselves, so we have to glorify ourselves through social media. Right or not? Self-promotion. Take our picture and put it to social media and check how many liked it. And if someone doesn't like it, suicide. How come my friend's picture are liked by so many people, my picture is not liked by people, so what's the use of this life? Suicide. And day before, he or she is writing in the Facebook or social media, I am very happy in my life. Next day, suicide. So, this is the reality. We are living in fantasy world. We are trying to show something which we are not. Right or not? So we don't look so wonderful what is shown in our Facebook profile picture. But that's why you have to put wonderful Facebook picture now. People will say, oh wow, what a look he has. Better to be connected. Let us have friendship with him. Because of what? Wonderful picture. But we are not so good looking. But in the picture?
Even the pictures are also not clear.
Yes. Then we are not so bad looking, whatever is shown in our Aadhaar card picture. So picture does not reflect the reality. The way the body does not reflect the reality of our existence. So it is a fantasy world. But people are so much enamored by this fantasy of this modern world, we forget our who we are. So Sanatana Goswami, when he met Mahaprabhu, he asked a question. Everybody is telling me that I am a scholar, I know so many things but I don't know. Who am I? In the same way, even after becoming devotee, you are also confused who you are. Like one? Well, who thought? Because you don't have relationship. Someone here. So Mahaprabhu told Sankarshan Goswami, Jivena Swarupai Krishna Nitya Das, relationship. Every living entity is a servant of Krishna. That is relationship. Unless and until we develop relationship, there is no question of happiness and joy in our life. And the real journey of relationship building begins with relationship with Krishna. That is the center of relationship. Krishna is the center of all relationship. That is the spiritual world and that is the real world. If there is no Krishna in our life, there is no question of any relationship. Because everything is fantasy. You understand? Clear? So relationship building can be done when we are Krishna conscious. Krishna should be the center of our relationship. You are from Calcutta. So Radha, Govinda, Srimad Mahaprabhu, Jagannath, Baladev, Subhadra should be the center of your relationship. If that center is not there, every relationship will be fantasy. Clear? You should write questions, write down your question because we will have. We'll spend more time on question answer. Yeah, 3:30 now. So how long we should have question answer? Depending on that, I will continue my talk. After first question, right? Na? You'll ask some question or I'll keep on speaking?
You speak later, no?
Yeah. So depending on that, I'll continue my discussion. And hopefully you can have question and answer for half an hour and there is no question. Okay. So it's clear that things cannot give us happiness. Because that is the principle of exploitation. Exploitation leads to frustration. And more you exploit, more you will be frustrated. The so-called successful people in this world are most frustrated people. More you go up in the ladder of so-called success, more you will be frustrated because they are isolated and alone. And many top successful person in this world reveal that they all experienced loneliness. Why people are feeling loneliness? Because they don't have any relationship. And because they don't know who they are, and that's why they could not develop any relationships. Even in the spiritual field also, some people, some practitioners, some spiritual seeker also feel lonely. Lonely. Why? Because they don't have relationship. And when you are lonely, you will be frustrated. So social relationship based on spiritual principle is the fundamental principle of our spiritual journey. We should not think that we can practice Krishna consciousness in isolation. So when Krishna goes to the forest with the cows, how many cows he takes with him?
Nine lakhs
is the cows, the number of cows for Nanda Maharaj. Vishwamanu Maharaj has double than that. If Nanda Maharaj has 9 lakhs, Vishwamanu Maharaj has 18 lakhs. Then other gopas, they don't have any cows or what? Krishna does not go with 9 lakh cows. He goes with unlimited number of cows. And unlimited number of calves. It is said asankhya. And what is the meaning of asankhya in terms of mathematics? 1 followed by 17 zeros. You can calculate later on, you are having some of you are maybe engineers, you can check later on. Asankhya means 1 followed by 17 zeros. That was the number of calves Krishna used to take for the field for grazing every day. Okay, lot of people. There is no scope of isolation. How many cowherd boys? I am not going to number again because this is not the mathematics class. Lot of cowherd boys. Again, countless number of cowherd boys. Then Krishna dances with gopis. How many gopis?
16,108.
Why you are laughing? Telling is right. Why you are laughing? Is not correct. That is called a normal gathering. Just like you came on with 30 boys. It doesn't mean that this one only has 30 boys. Your group has 30 boys. So, Krishna generally dances with the gopis in a normal condition, in normal rasa dance, with 16,108 gopis. But there is also an event which is known as Maharaslila. So there Krishna dances with how many gopis? 1 billion gopis. Don't become frustrated by hearing that. If I got 1 billion, you will make me able to write. Anybody? No. Definitely not. But how many will become old?
Everyone.
If you do certain things, you will not become old also. So you don't want to become old, but you have to become old. So that shows another symptom, that you don't have any control over our body. So how many of you can carry your property and your bank balance, credit card, debit card after you die? Please raise your hand. No? You are the owner, no? People are becoming very depressed by hearing my talk. I am trying to establish a point that we are not the controller. How many of you took birth with credit card, debit card, checkbook, and house? Please raise your hand. Nobody. Bad news. So you did not take birth with any of your property, and when you die, you will not carry any property with you. But in between, you claim that you are the owner. That is the proof of our condition. We are not the owner because we cannot control. But who is controlling? Anybody is controlling or not? Whether we believe in God or not, everybody accepts that someone else is controlling, not we. Deinasmin yatha dehe komaram jovanam jara tatha dehantara prapti nirastatra namihati. So Krishna is the enjoyer. Krishna is the proprietor. Why? Because he is the controller. Why is the controller? Why he can control everything? Because everything comes from him. He is the source of everything. Aham sarvasya prabhava matta sarvam prabhattate iti matta bhajante maam bhuda bhava samanyata. Because he is the source of everything, therefore he can control everything. And because we are not source of anything, so therefore we cannot control anything. But we have some little control because we are the secondary proprietor. But the primary proprietor and primary controller is Krishna. We control a little bit. Till we are alive, we control our possessions, we control our checkbook, bank book, whatever we have, we try to control, and we control to some extent. Because we are part and parcel of Krishna, insignificant controlling capacity we have. But we are secondary controller, insignificant controller. But ultimate controller is Krishna. We are subordinate to that control. That's why Krishna is the Supreme Personality of God. So why we become envious of others? Because we did not accept. Why Krishna will only enjoy? I want to enjoy. So this enjoyment spirit separately from Krishna is the root cause of our envy. When we separate Krishna from our life, when I and Krishna are separate, then envy is born. Krishna bhuli je bhagavan chakar nikatasto maya kare chapuriya. When we desire to enjoy, there is no problem in enjoying. In the spiritual world, people are enjoying unlimitedly with Krishna. But when we want to enjoy, keeping Krishna aside. When Krishna is not there in our life and we want to enjoy, and that is the place the envy is born. Separate mentality. Spiritual life means inclusive mentality. Vasudeva kutumbakam. Everybody is our own family member. Why? Because Krishna is the seed-giving father of all living entities. He is the father. Prabhupada used to say, there is no question of universal brotherhood if we don't accept one father. But Krishna is very clearly establishing this principle in Bhagavad Gita that he is the seed-giving father of everyone. And when you accept Krishna as our father, then everybody will be our brothers. And that is the principle of relationship. Krishna must be the center. If that vision is not there, if that understanding is not there, then we cannot have genuine relationship, spiritual relationship. So spiritual relationship fundamental principle is Krishna must be the center. And that is the meaning of Krishna consciousness. We don't have to give up anything. We just have to add Krishna in our life. Then everything will become wonderful. And Prabhupada used to say, if Krishna is not there, everything in this world is zero. Good birth in a good family, 1-0. You got a good job, 2-0. Graduate from a prestigious institution, 3-0. Got a job in America, 4-0. Got a wonderful wife, 5-0. Got a good business, 6-0. So, which is more valuable? 1-0? 2-0? 3-0? He said, "Oi, I am greater than you. Why? I am 3-0. You have only 1-0. So whether you have 1-0, 2-0, 3-0, 4-0, 5-0 is? 0. 0 means what? No value. In the same way, if you have everything, but Krishna is not there, life is a big 0. But if we add Krishna in our life, if you put 1 before the 0, if you have 1-0, it becomes 10. If you have 2-0, it becomes 100. If you have 3-0, 1,000. So value increases in multiplication. That is the potency of Krishna consciousness. Our life becomes so valuable and meaningful and joyful when we add Krishna in our life. Because when Krishna will be in our life, then our relationship will be wonderful. Everyone will have a loving relationship. Because Krishna is the center. Accepting Krishna is the enjoyer. Accepting Krishna is the proprietor. Accepting Krishna is the controller. We are the servant of Krishna. Divere Swarupai Krishna Nityadas. When we have that relationship, then everything will become wonderful. In this world, we always compare. Who is higher, who is lower? Who is more powerful, who is less powerful? Who has more money, who has less money? Who has big position, who has small position? Competition, unhealthy competition. But in the spiritual world, there is no comparison like that. Every soul is unique. There is no question of higher and lower or equal. Because every soul is unique. Just like in our body. We cannot say, oh, the ear is higher than eye. Our head is bigger than the leg. We cannot compare. Because in order to have a successful functioning body, we need all these limbs in our body. And every limb is unique, performing their services. Spiritual world is like that. Krishna is like the whole body. And we are different limbs of his body. And we all cooperate and serve him. Then we all become happy. And there is no question of comparing with each other. Because everyone is unique. But in this world, we are not happy. Why? Because we are always comparing. Okay, clear? And here, in this world, we are to become higher and higher and higher in position. In the corporate world, culture is, you should go up, up and up. Sky is the limit. If you stop going up, you are a dead person. Right or wrong? There is no limit of success. Success is defined by position. But you cannot be happy because there will be somebody above you all the time. And you will compare and you will be frustrated. And that is not our natural position also. It's an unnatural position. If you take out a fish out of the water, if you give him a 5-star hotel facility, he'll be happy? Never. Because a fish will be happy only in the waters. In the same way, a living entity, a jiva, a spirit soul, can only be happy when he is connected with Krishna. So that connection has to be established. And when that connection is established, then we experience happiness and joy in our life. So relationship means connecting with Krishna and connecting with ourselves, and together we get connected with Krishna. That is the principle of Vaishnava or devotee relationship. In the devotee relationship, we help each other to come closer to Krishna, to help each other to become more connected with Krishna. That is the principle of relationship in devotee community. So in this devotee community, we don't have any other goal than come closer to Krishna. If you have any other goal than this, then again we will experience frustration in our life, not joy. Because as soon as we have our own ambition and goal, we get disconnected from Krishna. And disconnection from Krishna will lead to frustration. So, devotee community means helping each other to create a loving bond with Krishna and also creating a loving bond amongst ourselves, keeping Krishna in that center. That is the success of our spiritual life. We cannot experience happiness in isolation. We cannot experience the joy of Krishna consciousness in isolation. In the same way, if we come into the community of devotees and we have our own selfish motive, we also cannot experience joy in Krishna consciousness. So in order to have healthy relationship, we have to give up our selfish motive. What motive we should have? We should always have the motive to please Krishna. We should always have the motive to serve Krishna. We should always have the motive to serve other devotees. We should always have the motive to help other devotees in bringing them closer to Krishna. That is the principle of devotee relationship. And Prabhupada established ISKCON about that, so that we can enrich our relationship as devotees and help each other to come closer to Krishna and perfect our aim and form of life by becoming fully Krishna conscious. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Srila Prabhupada ki jaya, samaveta bhaktavrinda ki jaya.